learning. In this algorithm, example is show logistic regression predicting magazine subscription based on certain key features. And we just drop a OBSNO column. It's not necessary. And in our columns, we have by, income, is female, is married, has college, is professional, is retired, unemployed, residence length, dual income, minors, own, house, white, English, previous magazine, child magazine, previous parent magazine. And so we'll look at these features: income, is female, is married, has college, is professional, English, previous child magazine, pre-magazine, and then we'll fit that in there. Let's see, one other one. Let's see, I want to check to see by income, unemployed. Let's grab that one too. Don't see that in the list. Okay, so we'll just add that. Let's see if that one, that feature there. Okay, now we'll go ahead and run it. And so we do a train test split at 20%. We use our logistic regression. Didn't hyperparameter tune, I just used C of 100. It seemed to work pretty good. Let's see what would happen here. 100. Okay, let's drop that down to 10. Run it. See what it says. And drop that to 0.1. So I don't think it's making a difference in the prediction capability. Okay. But we could definitely hyperparameter tune this later if we wanted. Okay, so now we'll just do some counts, and we're gonna look at the subscription counts by 0 or 1, yes or no. And so we have a total of 548, and this is using the data frame value counts, and we can see that we can also do the data frame by value counts and put it into a count plot. So there's two ways that you can plot it. You can just plot it just with dot plot, or you can use count plots. So count plots is less code than, and then you can get your not by and by pattern. Okay, so now what we'll do is look at the accuracy. We'll put it into an ROC curve, and you can see that it's got kind of an exponential curve, a little choppy here, but not bad in terms of the true positives rate and false positive rates. And then we have a log loss. Log loss is a function that we have defined up here and just imported it in, and that tells us the amount of error that we are occurring. And you can focus in on some a log loss on kind of like on your training set and our fitting set to get better fit, and we'll look at how that's possible. Okay, so now what we want to do is look at logistic or lasso fit, and we'll just set up a number of variables here, and let's just see which one is most important. And you can see that unemployed is very important. You can have all these other features, but if a person's unemployed, they're probably not going to subscribe. And then we can put it into our confusion matrix and see how accurate it was. True negatives, true positives, 88% on the logistic regression. And then what we're going to do is ridge is used to determine if overfitting has occurred. So let me just go ahead and print that out. And so we want, you want a set, you want small values of ridge. So ridge is used to determine if overfitting has occurred. You want small values of ridge. And so here's our plot. The ridge score tells how good the classifier is fitting the data. Okay, so now we want to see how well our classifier does against production data. So we'll do some cross folds. We'll do 5 cross folds of the data. And there are our scores, 86, 88, 87, 64, 74. So one of the folds that didn't do too well, but the other ones were up in the 80% and close to 80%. All right, thanks for listening. Happy Python coding.